Welcome back to Drinks Made Easy, because cocktails don't have to be difficult, much like this recipe. During the colder months, a Kentucky mulled cider can be an awesome and super easy cocktail to make in small amounts for yourself, or you can batch them, and it's a great easy thing to have for your parties. If you haven't already, please go ahead and click on the bell icon and the subscribe button so you'll be notified every time we release a new video. And if you have any suggestions or comments, please be sure to leave them below. Without any further ado, let's make a cocktail. To make the Kentucky mulled cider, you'll start with 32 ounces or 1 quart of the apple cider of your choice. Now, this is not going to be a sparkling cider or an alcohol cider, at least for this recipe, but if you have one that's already spiked, you can use that, but just adjust your alcohol accordingly. Next, you'll add 1 cup or 8 ounces of bourbon, 3 halves of cinnamon sticks, or depending on the size. So these are, you know, your regular, maybe 3.5-inch cinnamon sticks. Sometimes you're buying the really big ones. Crack those in half, count them as 2, otherwise you're gonna have a really overpowering amount of cinnamon in your mulled cider. Next we'll add 3 whole allspice berries, 5 whole cloves, and 6 whole black peppercorns. Now this is something where you can also play around with different types of peppercorns if you have ones that you particularly enjoy. Doing a combination of pink, black, and white peppercorns can sometimes add a really nice roundness to the pepper that you're adding to your cider. And then once you have that all together, just put it over medium-low heat and cover it for approximately 1 hour. You want to make sure you don't bring it to a simmer or a boil, or you'll start to both condense your cider and you risk burning off some of that alcohol. Once you've allowed the ingredients to blend together over heat for at least an hour, you can ladle it out into the glass of your choice and garnish with a wedge of lemon and a little piece of cinnamon. Now, another thing you can do that I enjoy is if you have the longer cinnamon sticks, you can actually use those as a straw, especially if you like a lot of cinnamon, as I do, in your mulled drinks. Now, if you're batching larger amounts, scale up with the amount of spice and bourbon, etc., and conversely, scale down if you're doing smaller portions. If you use the amount of allspice, clove, and cinnamon in a batch of 1 or 2 of these, as we did in this whole quart of cider, it's gonna get really, really strong in terms of those mulling spices to the point where oftentimes it's not very good. Try it out and let us know what you think, and leave a comment below. Until next time, cheers from Drinks Made Easy.